Hello everyone. It is so wonderful to welcome you here today to celebrate the achievements of your loved ones. Like you, we are immensely proud of all they have achieved, in their qualifications, certainly, but perhaps even more so in developing their character, personality, and resilience. It is my great honor to introduce the Bangkok Prep Orchestra, and later, our vocalist today, Preem, to accompany the entrance of our class of 2023 and begin the Bangkok Prep graduation for 2023.
Thank you. Good afternoon, year 13. It's my honor to welcome you to your graduation ceremony. As you were walking down the steps, looking grown up, very grown up, I still remembered you as primary children at 53, and then teenagers. I have watched you play, learn, and grow. You have brought us, and will always bring us so much joy. Today, we celebrate your excellence and achievements, and we do so with the people who nurtured and supported you at home. It takes good soil, water, and light to grow a seedling. Before me today, I see so many strong and mighty oak trees. As you received your diplomas at this milestone in your lives, please be resolute that you will continue to find things you need to learn and grow. Like light, understanding and education can come from many sources. Keep your minds open and always learn. Like water, love can be everywhere, or sometimes it seems hard to find. You will always have water if you can love the person you are. You have started your life with excellent soil. Tend and add to it. Your branches and reach will be huge. I know this about Bangkok Prep class of 2023, because you have and always will have your roots firmly with your family as part of our community. Well done, class 13. You have done so well and have so much to offer the world. Congratulations to each and every one of you. Now, let's welcome Mr. Stonehouse, our head of school, to share his opening remarks.
Thank you, Compatriota. Esteemed students, distinguished faculty members, honored guests, and proud parents. Today we gather here to commemorate a momentous occasion, the graduation of our remarkable year 13. As most are preparing their journey for the university stages, this ceremony signifies the culmination of years of hard work, dedication, and intellectual growth. As head of school, it's my privilege to address this exceptional group of young individuals. As Lottie's father, it's also a great privilege to be here today amongst all the parents in the auditorium. Only 7 years ago, I gave this message as then the head of primary. I wished good luck to the year sixes. We gave them a red rose as they joined the secondary school. Time certainly passes by when you're enjoying yourself. As parents, these moments, these rites of passage, we must cherish, for it is truly an honor to be a parent for these beautiful children. Year 13, you are now adults in the true sense of the word, and the majority of you will be moving away from home. As you grow older, your political and spiritual belief systems evolve. We are defined by our own personal spirituality, and in fact, our belief in the magical and mystical defines us as individuals as we mature into adulthood. How many of you year 13s graduating today believe in fairies? Please indulge me. Can you just raise your hand if you believe in fairies? Thank you, Maher. Thank you. I'm going to tell you something today that hopefully will change the way you live your lives. May I be so bold to suggest that actually most of you do, in fact, believe in fairies. Many of you believe in a very special mystical person called the magical tidy fairy. Have you ever wondered that when your clothes are on the piles and the floors of your bedrooms and scattered around the house, and you go to school and when you get home, the magical tidy fairy has tiptoed in, they've waved their magic wand, and all of your clothes have been meticulously washed, carefully ironed. This helpful fairy has even taken time to fold your clothes, iron them, and place them in neatly in your wardrobes. You know the one, you know, the same fairy that clears away your bowls and cups and your plates, your food panda takeaway cartons. cleans your tables, vacuums your floors, puts fresh clean sheets on your beds, and scrubs the toilets. Be aware, these fairies don't actually exist. This is just simply another job on the long list of parents' dedicated duties. I must apologise to some parents if you are sitting there thinking, actually, I think there is a tidy fairy that does exist in our household, and each month they have a very good salary for a job, very good and very well done. Embarrassingly, I did actually take a moment to think, I'm not sure where my iron and ironing board is in our house, actually. And of course, not to mention the other fairy, the fantastic fridge-filling fairy who goes to work when the door is closed and the lights are off and fills up your fridge with delicious food. Chocolate, fresh milk, sweets. I decided not to mention the cash flow fairy, who magically remotely tops up your bank account when you run low on money. Actually, I think following the technological modernization of global banking system and the transformation to a QR cashless society during the age of millennials and Gen Z alignment, I'm sure you'd rather be calling this fairy the sort of K-Bank fairy or K-Bank transfer fairy or the Sakan fairy. Year 13s, don't be under any illusions. Believe me, these fairies will not exist when you live away from home and from your parents. On this matter, I have 2 points. First point, you will need to learn to do this yourself, or you will fall into the trap like millions of other students. You will live in an unkempt house, which isn't much fun, with smelly, dirty, overflowing rubbish bins everywhere. So please try and avoid that. The second point, and much more importantly, when you move away, you will truly appreciate what your parents do for you. I implore you to thank them wholeheartedly later this afternoon. Please remember that their unconditional loving support has been offered for you all the way through your childhood. Can you take a moment now to applaud your parents? Thank you. Thank you, parents. University life will present you undoubtedly with unparalleled opportunities to pursue your passion, deepen your knowledge, and engage with some of the brightest minds in academia. Embrace these challenges that lie ahead of you, for they will mould you into resilient individuals, equipped to tackle the complexities of an ever-evolving world. Without doubt, the future technology will play a really important part in our lives. And you, as year 13s, move forward into the realms of higher education, it's imperative that you recognise that technology is a tool, one that must be wielded thoughtfully and ethically. As future professionals, scientists, lawyers, artists, and leaders, you have the responsibility to understand the implications of technology and leverage it for the good of society. While you may use TikTok, BeReal, Snapchat, Instagram, remember that this true success is not measured solely by virtual metrics. It lies on the impact that you make, the lives you touch, and the positive change that you can bring about the world. As you navigate your university years, channel your energy and talents towards endeavors that will leave a lasting and meaningful legacy. May I also implore you to be an advocate of freedom of speech. I was pleased to hear that 21 days ago in the UK, there was a landmark legislation which ensured universities protect and promote freedom of speech on campuses, fulfilling a manifesto promising to bolster academic freedom. This newly passed Freedom of Speech Act will ensure that universities promote this fundamental value. So please support a free society which requires debate. We should all be encouraged to engage respectfully with others' ideas. Year 13s, to your teachers, I extend my heartfelt gratitude to these dedicated teachers, these mentors who have nurtured you and guided you through your educational journey. Their unwavering support and belief in your potential have laid the foundations for your achievements, and for that, we are eternally grateful. Please may we applaud the teachers. And to the class of 2023, as you embark on this new exciting chapter, I implore you to embrace the unknown with courage and curiosity. seek knowledge, foster friendships, and seize every opportunity that you can to grow intellectually and personally. Remember that your education extends beyond the confines of the classroom. It's a lifelong pursuit that should fuel your thirst for knowledge and inspire you to make a positive impact on society. In conclusion, I offer my sincere congratulations to each and every one of you. May your university years be filled with passion, purpose, and wisdom to navigate the world responsibly. As you forge your paths ahead, may your endeavours be met with great success and fulfilment. Good luck, class of 23. Thank you.
Many thanks indeed, Mr. Stonehouse, for those heartfelt words and a comprehensive guide to fairies. Year 13, one of the reasons that our guest speaker is here today is because we asked you, who can we invite to deliver our keynote address? And you made an important connection. The other very important reason is that our guest of honour accepted the invitation, and for that we are very grateful. Mr. Korn Chatigawanin served as Finance Minister of the Kingdom of Thailand from 2008 to 2011. He was born in London, studied in Thailand and Oxford. Much of Khun Korn's career was spent in the finance sector, beginning with his work at SG Warburg, London. He went on to co-found, chair and lead international investment banks. Khun Korn has received Global Finance Minister of the Year and Asia Pacific Finance Minister of the Year awards. In 2004, Khun Korn reached a significant point in his own pathway, and he chose to focus on serving the community through politics. When Khun Korn was just a few years older than you are now, year 13, he graduated with a BA with honours in philosophy, politics and economics from St. John's College at the University of Oxford. His story and achievements are remarkable. Like you, he began his journey supported by his hard work, tenacity, and superb education. Please join me in welcoming Khun Korn Chatigawanid to the stage.
Thank you very much for that very generous introduction. Hello, everybody. Obviously, big congratulations for all of you in blue. It's a big day for everybody, not just for the graduating 71, class of 23, but a huge day for the parents as well. As a parent of the recently graduated, I know how proud you must feel today, tinged also with a sense of relief. That you managed to reach this day. Congratulations also to the teaching staff. Big day for you. This is the product of your hard and excellent work, so very well done. I may be a politician, but I promise I'll be brief. The one thing that's obvious today is that it's a happy day. Happy day for most of you, but a happy day that will be tinged with a bit of sadness as well, I'm sure. Obviously happy because, you know, you finished your A-levels recently, and you'll be moving on to bigger and almost certainly better things. But tinged with sadness because pretty soon you'll be leaving a place that you're familiar with, saying goodbye to many faces that you'll be familiar with. But for all of you, I've got good news. And even for those of you, and if we're to be entirely honest, some of you will not necessarily have felt that you've been entirely fulfilled so far by school. The good news for everybody is that where most of you will be going on to next, which is university, life will be even better. It's a chance to reboot, start again. It's a fresh canvas, and it's a very much bigger canvas. So for all of you who may not yet feel totally fulfilled, the chances are at university you will be meeting people of like minds, meeting soulmates. You'll be discovering what your true passions are. And these are the promises that awaits all of you. I recall still my first week at university at Oxford. In the first week, one of the things that we have to do is we're asked to go into a little pep talk. It's a one-on-one pep talk with one of the dons. And during that pep talk, I remember important piece of advice that was given to each of the newbies. The advice was that at university, there are really three main options that you can choose from in terms of what you do, how you spend your time at university. The first option, most obvious one, study hard. The second option is that university is an opportunity, as the headmaster just mentioned, to find and follow your passion. That might be in sports, that might be in the arts, that might be in journalism, politics, whatever it is. But find your passion and delve into it. And the third option, also obvious, that is just to party hard and have a good time. And these were the options that were laid out to all of us, new intakes at Oxford back in 1982. And we were further advised that if we wanted to achieve a good degree, a first-class degree, then we would be advised to choose just the first option, study hard. But if you were to be happy with walking away with a second-class degree, then maybe you can choose the first option, study hard, and one of the other two. But by in no account should you try to do all three, unless you're willing to risk getting a third-class degree. Now, I ended up with a third-class degree, although I have to say that I enjoyed every moment of my time at university. And that's the thing. University, if nothing else, will be the first and the last truly free time, the first truly freedom that you will feel for in your life. And that carries important consequences. It means that you need to be very conscious of the decision that you make in terms of how you spend your 3 years or your 4 years or even your 5 years at university, because it is the only true freedom that you're going to have for the rest of your life. Now, when I first went up to university, I was a little bit lost with this freedom that I had. I ended up smoking cigarettes because I couldn't do so before at school. I drank too much. I traveled to London every weekend to join my friends for parties. But I very quickly realized that that wasn't how I wanted to spend my freedom. And I decided that I would use the freedom I had to try to follow up on a particular passion and a question that I had in my own mind, and that was in sports. I wanted to know how far I could go in my chosen sports, which was rowing. Luckily, I was at Oxford, so I could do that. And so I committed myself for the next 2 or 3 years, mainly with a life on the river. So whatever you do, and it could be the arts, as I said, it could be music, it could be anything. Choose carefully, choose consciously, and commit your time to it. Even if you don't end up being very successful at it, and I wasn't a very successful oarsman, at least you can use that freedom to learn more about yourself and to follow the passion that you have. Serious life comes after university. It may appear to you today that the most important thing that you need to achieve from now on is getting a very good degree. Well, a good degree is important, but the journey towards getting that degree will prove to be more lasting in terms of its impact on your life. So having a goal is important, but always remember, live the moment. The journey is more important. And serious life afterwards, well, it can wait. There's no hurry. Some of you may already know exactly what you want to do with your life. Well, I can assure you, after university, many of you who think you know today will be changing your minds. Many of you will not have a clue what you want to do after university. Well, don't feel bad about that. I think that's actually quite normal. The whole thing about university is an opportunity to open our minds. So keep your mind open for new ideas, new opportunities, and start your serious life after. the final comment I'd like to leave with you is that the very fact that you're here at Bangkok Prep in a graduating ceremony means that you are not even the top 1% of Thai or even global society, but you're going to be nearer the top 0.1%. And in my books, that means you carry a responsibility. You carry a responsibility later on in life to give back. To give back the opportunities that you've had, your parents have given you, your teachers have given you, to those who haven't. So go forth to your university career, and always remember, I want you all to come back to Thailand and to contribute to society and create the opportunities that you've all had the privilege to enjoy. So before I depart, I want to leave you with one last comment made by one of my favorite sporting personalities, a guy called Rafael Nadal, tennis player, because I know you're a little bit nervous today about the ceremony, maybe, probably more about the A-level results that you're waiting for, and then about your life at university, first time away from home for many of you. Well, Nadal said, don't be afraid of nerves. Being nervous is good. Keeps you on edge, it keeps you sharp. I believe that. So stay sharp, be lucky, stay committed, and very good luck for the rest of your life. Come back and help our country. Thank you very much.
Thank you to our guest speaker, Khun Khorn. We really appreciate your time and your words of wisdom. Thank you. Year 13, I am so happy and proud to be here celebrating your graduation with you today. Your tutors are going to invite you onto stage for you to collect your diplomas. Please, can I invite Mr. Riley? I would now like to welcome our honored guests to take center stage.
Good afternoon, everybody. So first up, we have Taz, who has made a significant impact on the school during his time here. His sense of humor never fails to lighten the mood in the classroom, and his leadership as house captain and varsity football captain has been invaluable. We are confident that he will continue to bring laughter and inspiration to those around him during his studies in the UK. Senna has proven herself to be a diligent student with an outstanding work ethic, earning the respect and admiration of her peers and educators alike. Her kindness and love for animals, especially her 12 pet dogs, demonstrates her compassionate nature and her potential to make a positive impact on the world. AIM has consistently demonstrated an exceptional attitude, putting her heart and soul into everything she does. AIM co-founded the Episodes of Us project, which focused on building a love of self and has projects that expand to other schools beyond Bangkok Prep, a testament to her compassion and community-mindedness to make a positive impact. Aria has proven herself to be an outstanding leader as Surah's house captain and varsity basketball captain. She has also shown a talent for the arts, putting on a fantastic performance as a dancer in the school production. Outside of school, she enjoys keeping fit and healthy by running at the park and drinking nutritious matcha. TJ has spent an incredible 15 years at this school. His contributions to the Student Action Team, as well as the Economic Society, have been invaluable. TJ, we are confident that you will continue to inspire those around you at Chulalongkorn University. Congratulations, TJ. Asha is unquestionably a dedicated and talented student, but that is not all. Asha is also a star athlete, serving as the captain of the varsity basketball team and leading his fellow teammates to victory time and time again. He leads by example and has made lifelong friends on and off the court. Mind truly embodies the qualities of a great leader. In her leadership positions in the equality team, student action team, and as Sabre House vice captain, Mind has shown her unwavering commitment to driving positive change in the school community. Through episodes of Us, her positive impact has been made far beyond just Bangkok Prep. Grace is an outstanding student leader who led Sarah's House to a thunderous victory during Sports Day this year. Grace's leadership skills, her commitment to sports, and her positive and approachable nature have made her an invaluable, inspirational, and cherished member of the school community. Tin's diligence as an ICT prefect and keen member of the Economic Society make him a valued member of our school. As Tin embarks on his journey to university, we are confident that he will continue to inspire those around him, and we wish him all the best in his future endeavors. Sanskriti is a brilliant student who has worked tirelessly during her A-levels. In addition to her academic excellence, Sanskriti has a fantastic singing voice and had the courage to showcase it in front of the entire school at Live from the Undercroft. Thank you, Sanskriti. Sean's dry wit and humor has undoubtedly kept us all entertained on a daily basis, and his ability to form deep and lasting friendships is testament to the kind person he is. Sean's passion and impressive talent for computer science and stock investments will certainly serve him well in the future. As deputy head girl and the founding member of Smile Club, Pincher has demonstrated her leadership skills and her commitment to making a positive impact in her community. Additionally, her talent as a writer has earned her recognition from the prestigious New York Times, and her offer to study at Cambridge University reflects her academic excellence. Aya's friendly and bubbly nature, combined with her valuable contributions to the football team, are a big part of the attributes that she should be celebrated for. We are thrilled to see Aya pursue her dream of studying medicine next year, knowing that her dedication and leadership abilities will serve her well in this new chapter of her life. Danny's kind and caring nature has enabled him to form close friendships with many of his peers. We are certain that Danny's spirit of kindness and friendship will continue to positively affect those around him in all his future endeavors. Sarin has served as an outstanding leader during his time at Bangkok Prep. His unwavering dedication to his academic pursuits is a testament to the commitment he has to excellence. We wish Sarin all the best as he moves on to new adventures in London. Well done, 13DR. You've made us all very proud.
Thank you, Mr. Riley. Please can I now invite Mr. Gosling onto the stage.
Good afternoon, everyone. Tar was voted Mr. Olympia but also most likely to be homeless by his friends at the Year 13 Awards. The fact that Tar received two awards shows just how popular he is. We'll be sure to see Tar on the PGA Tour at some point, but for now we wish him well as he goes off to study international business in America. King, or Boss, as I've just learned he likes to be called, is a very unique individual, creative, easygoing, and appears to be at ease with himself. He also describes himself as a little bit weird sometimes. We like that, King. His favorite memory was the final day of the Year 13 residential trip. Perhaps ask him why after this. King will be moving on to study communication design. Prim. Throughout her time at Bangkok Prep, Prim has been amazing. Despite juggling a very demanding international training and performance schedule outside of school, she has formed friendships that will last her forever. Her charisma and kind-heartedness will be great, will be a great foundation for her as she goes on to study economics and finance at Bentley University in Massachusetts. Akash. Akash is an outspoken, energetic, yet pragmatic young man who has made the most of, of his time at Bangkok Prep. He feels his biggest achievement was getting an A in his extended project qualification on the 2008 financial crisis. His dream job would be to work in finance for an F1 team. We wish Akash well as he goes off to study commerce at the University of Melbourne. Preem. Although Preem may be softly spoken, she is always heard. During her years in our sixth form, she quickly became a very vocal part of the community, becoming leader of the eco team and a vital member of many community projects that help raise money for valuable causes. Preem loves a challenge, which led her to study all three sciences and mathematics, along with her leadership and extracurricular responsibilities. Preem will deservedly go on to study medicine at Thammasat University. Kayon. Kayon is a patient, caring, and thoughtful member of the Year 13 team. Her favorite memory was the Year 11 geography field trip when the students spent time together applying their skills in real life. Even though she loved it, it just wasn't enough to convince her to take geography at A-level. We wish Kayon the very best as she goes on to study finance in Hong Kong. Well done. Rishab. Rishab is certainly one of Bangkok Prep's most academically gifted students. 100% in the UK MT Maths competition, 4 A's at AS, predicted 4 A stars at A level, and completing A level maths 1 year early. Rishab's favorite memory at Bangkok Prep was shaking his maracas at the Year 9 Prep's Got Talent event. Rishab will be studying either engineering at either Cambridge or Georgia Tech, a wonderful choice to make. Congratulations, and don't forget those maracas. Rinka. Rinka is an adventurous and considerate student who likes to set high targets for herself. An avid tennis player, she was a key member of the tennis team up to year 11. Rinka loves learning about many different cultures at Bangkok Prep, and she leaves us to go and study bioenvironmental sciences in Japan. Congratulations, Rinka. Nora. Nora is an independent, respectful, and caring student. During the pandemic, travel restrictions affected her more than most, and Nora showed a great deal of tenacity to continue learning when she couldn't come back to Thailand. Her resilience and resourcefulness bode well for her as she carries on her passion for photography at UAL, where she will study photojournalism and documentary photography. Somjin loves design and is extremely creative. She includes completing her art and DT coursework and being an art prefect as some of her proudest achievements at Bangkok Prep. Somjin has made great friends in our sixth form and will be staying in Thailand to continue her education at Chulalongkorn University studying design and architecture. Perhaps designing buildings is next on her list of achievements. Mimi. Mimi loves to be creative and is very passionate about art. She joined Bangkok Prep all the way back in year 7 and enjoys hanging out with her friends and going on residentials the most. Mimi is an incredibly talented artist and intends to study art and technology at the Pratt Institute in Brooklyn, New York. We look forward to seeing your work in the future. Divi. Divi describes himself as practical and quick-witted, and we agree. Whether it be the house leader, council rep, or leader of the economic society, Divi has always played an active role in a school community. He has two favorite memories, receiving an Economic Student of the Month award and a 2 out of 20 in an economics test in the same lesson. Life is full of highs and lows, Divi. The second is sitting at the back of the bus with his friends for the very emotional last bus ride of the year 13 residential. April is a caring and friendly student who was always full of energy each morning, and that in turn brightens the room she is in. Her favorite memory is making lots of friends and getting involved in all the community events. April is very proud to have been accepted to study biomedical sciences at King's College in London, a subject close to her heart because she loves bacteria. Mumu. Mumu is a truly passionate, determined, and outgoing student who joined Bangkok Prep all the way back in year 8. Mumu is really proud of the fact she's never had a directed time, and her favorite memory has been going on residentials and hanging out with all of her good friends. Mumu intends to study marketing management at Syracuse University in New York State. Well done. GM. GM is a fun and happy-go-lucky young man. When he's not doing coursework, GM can be found on the basketball court. In fact, he was often found there by the teachers he owed coursework to. GM's favorite memory from Bangkok Prep was the year 13 residential and Prep's Got Talent, where he got to showcase his drumming skills. GM will be going on to Switzerland to study for a degree in the culinary arts. Well done. Thank you to everyone in 13MG.
Thank you, Mr. Gosling. I'd now like to invite Miss Aurora onto stage.
Thank you. I'm so proud to be calling you to collect your diplomas today. It's been wonderful to see you grow up together. Jemmy has been a studious learner who has applied herself in and outside of the classroom. Her leadership roles include the executive academic prefect, the vice president of the Economic Society, the head of research at Smile Club, and playing volleyball and football during her time at sixth form. Her hardworking and enthusiastic nature will bring her the success in her pursuit of a law degree in the UK. Joy. Joy joined Bangkok Prep in 2008 and has been with us since nursery. Joy has since worked diligently to achieve her ambitions. She's proactive and can be relied upon to take complete ownership of her learning, which is truly an asset in achieving her medicine degree at university. Her lovely smile and positive attitude in form will be missed. Krishna. Krishna joined the school in nursery as is the embodiment of the life values we instill here at Bangkok Prep. Her kind, hardworking, and supportive nature has been invaluable for the school community over the last 15 years. Not only has she engaged in several charity projects and is a key member for the Eco Team and the Smile Club, but her leadership skill ranges from being a house leader to the president of the Medical Society. Ritika. Ritika has been a hardworking student and a role model for others, often being praised for her mature and studious approach. Outside the classroom, Ritika continues to develop her leadership skills by being a part of the student service group. Her proudest moment was when she managed to deadlift 80 kilograms after only training for 2 weeks. She's a great scientist who enjoys biology and plans to study medicine at university. Jay. Jay has proven to be a very resilient and dedicated student who's never missed a day of sixth form. His discipline led him and his team to make history when they finished fourth at the BISB Sevens football tournament. His strong academic talent, cheerful manner, and great sense of humor will bring him all the success at university. Leo. Leo is a very sociable and polite student with a unique sense of humor and a strong network of friends. He describes himself as super good looking and enjoys sharing his views in discussions with his peers and teachers. He has made incredible progress this academic year and has been the recipient of several Student of the Month awards. We wish Leo the best of luck studying business in the UK. Megan. Megan is an incredibly valuable member of the Bangkok Prep team who, although is determined to fulfill her academic ambitions, has also committed herself to develop her creative and athletic talents. She performed confidently in the Live at the Undercroft and won first place in the singing competition. Megan leaves us to study pharmacology in Australia. Pear. Pear has significantly excelled in her academics since joining Bangkok Prep. Pear has also added to her experience and learning by shadowing medical staff to gain valuable experience for her future career, showing her dedication and commitment. We wish Pear all the best in her plans to study dentistry in Thailand. Meher. Since joining Bangkok Prep in year three, Meher has always displayed a lot of energy and enthusiasm for life. She's an extremely sociable character who empathizes with those around her. Her proudest moments in Bangkok Prep include becoming the first ever editor-in-chief for the Prep Gazette, the A-level drama performances, and creating her media A-level music video. We look forward to seeing her productions on the big screen in the near future. Ramez. Ramez is a great example of someone who looks to learn from the wider world. We're immensely proud of the kind and mature young man that walks across the stage today. He has been a member of the Bangkok Prep community since 2016 and has made incredible academic progress this year in BTech IT coursework. His kindness and positivity will help him achieve success in university and beyond. Zara. During her 15 years at school, Zara has matured brilliantly. She's a key member of the Smile Club Economic Society and has positively contributed to the school community. Her diligence, resilience, and leadership skills will be an incredible asset to any educational institution. Zara's passion for business is admirable, and we're certain to see her company listed in the stock market. Mook. Mook's confidence has blossomed throughout her time in sixth form. That is wonderful to see, as Mook has had so much to offer others. Mook's independent approach in preparation for any academic challenges are second to none and are sure to be an absolute asset in her life at university and beyond. We wish her all the best studying business at Chulalongkorn University. Nadol. Nadol is an industrious student who took up the challenge of successfully completing four A-levels. This has only been achievable due to his attentive, disciplined, and resilient nature. His skills and knowledge extend beyond the classroom, where he's been the vice captain for Thuris and a very keen football player. Beneath the quiet exterior, Nadol is a humorous and strong-willed individual who's clearly well-respected by his peers. Prompon. Prompon joined Bangkok Prep in nursery. During her time at Bangkok Prep, Prompon has shown adaptability, resilience, and dedication to the wider community. She has pushed beyond her comfort zone and made the most of the opportunities she had, notably in her role as the whole school student council leader and a key member of the student service team. Prompon has excelled in economics and is truly an inspirational student. Moe. Mo is a diligent, loyal, and friendly individual who has allowed her to make a strong network of friends. She wants to give a special shout out to Pear and Megan, who are a significant part of her favorite memories she's created at Bangkok Prep. I'm sure they feel the same way, Mo. We would also like to thank Moy for all her contributions to the tutor time quizzes and the Wordle challenges. Congratulations, 13A. It's been a pleasure to be your form teacher.
Good afternoon, students, families, and esteemed guests. The Dr. Sipanon Award is the school's most prestigious and highly acclaimed academic award and is the result of ultimate dedication, hard work, and resilience. Dr. Sipanon was one of the founders of Bangkok Prep and was a remarkable person and a great thinker. He played a major role in shaping education reform in Thailand, as well as the formulation of the mechanism for providing research grants. Dr. Sipanon trained as a nuclear physicist, had a wide-ranging career from services in academia, government, politics, industry, and business. These awards are named in his honor for good reason. The award is given to one student in each year group with the highest academic achievement across all subjects studied. I would like to call to the stage Kun Teresa, our Deputy Manager of Strategy and Human Resources, and the daughter of the late Dr. Sipanon, to present the award. It is a huge honor and privilege to announce the winner of the Dr. Sipanon Award goes to Joy.
Thank you, guests. If you'd like to take a seat for me, please. Okay, good afternoon, everyone. A huge congratulations to 13DR, 13MG, and 13NA on graduating, and of course, Joy for winning such a prestigious award. I would now like to introduce to you our very own Megan Harrington, who will be performing Perfect by Ed Sheeran.
Found a love for me, darling, just dive right in and follow my lead. Well, I found a girl, beautiful and sweet. Oh, I never knew you were the someone waiting for me. We were just kids when we fell in love, not knowing what it was. I will not keep you up this time. Darling, just kiss me slow. Your heart is all I own, and in your eyes, your hope. Baby, I'm dancing in the dark with you between my arms, barefoot on the grass, listening to our favorite song. When you said you looked a mess, I whispered underneath my breath, but you heard it, darling, you won't look perfect tonight. Well, I found a woman stronger than anyone I know. She shares my dreams. I hope that someday I'll share a home and I found a love to carry more than just my secrets, to carry love, to carry children of our own. And we are still kids, but we're so in love, fighting against all odds. I know we'll be alright this time. But darling, just hold my hand, be my girl, I'll be your man. I see my future in your eyes. Baby, I'm dancing in the dark with you between my arms, barefoot on the grass, listening to our favorite song. When I saw you in that dress, looking so beautiful, I don't deserve this, darling. You look perfect tonight. Whoa, baby, I'm dancing in the dark with you between my arms, barefoot on the grass, listening to our favorite song. I have faith in what I see. Now I know I have met an angel in person, and she looks perfect. I don't deserve this. You look perfect tonight.
Come back on now. What a wonderful performance. Thank you so much, Megan. Okay, we now move to the final two forms to receive their diplomas today. We're going to start with 13SD. Please can I welcome Miss Dand to the stage. I would also like to welcome our honoured guest back to centre stage.
Good afternoon, everyone. Win. I will always remember Wynne as a smiley student who could not stop playing chess long enough for the register to be taken. He's also a student who helps to bring the form and the year group together with his infectious positivity. Wynne is looking forward to studying accounting in Thailand next year. Francis, Franny B. What an incredible leader. Multifaceted academic and community-spirited member of the Bangkok Prep community. Frances's skills have helped her triumph in every way possible in her 15 years here, whether that be in her role as head girl, winning football cups, or participating in World Scholars Cup and the self-titled Super Cool Debate Club. Next year, she'll be studying law with a scholarship from the University of York. Jan. Jan, with her infectious laugh, is definitely a student who has made the most of her 13 years at prep. Jan has taken part in a huge range of extracurricular activities. We would not have time to name them all. When studying economics next year, Jan will reflect fondly on her time sitting under B block and on floor 5 playing cards and games with her friends. Raina. Raina has been at Bangkok Prep for 12 years, being a part of basketball, football, swimming, and economics ECAs. Raina's determination and independence will see her thrive studying business administration and marketing next year. Raina brings a welcome sense of calm with her. That is a very positive feeling for those around her. Congratulations, Raina. Namon. Namon, an incredibly hard-working student who has taken part in almost as many ECAs as she has had hair colours. Namon has contributed to every aspect of school life, notably through varsity badminton, maths mentoring, charity work, and as the head of operations of the Economic Society. A huge contribution, Namon. In these ways, you've been an excellent role model to others. Thank you. Sriracha. Sriracha always ensures there is a light-hearted and fun element to each morning during form time. Her outstanding performances in her A-level drama pieces, as well as whole school shows, have ensured she will remain as a drama legend for years to come. Studying media, screen studies, and drama, we are sure to see Sriracha's name in lights. Purich. Purich is an extremely versatile student who you may see dominating at basketball before school, performing wonderful live music at break time, collecting psychology awards at lunchtime, and then mentoring younger students in maths after school clubs. He's a good-humoured individual who you can always count on to lighten the mood. Minnie. Minnie joined Bangkok Prep in year five and has been an enthusiastic and sincere member of the school community. Minnie has given her time and talents as part of our Bangkok Prep Orchestra and plans to study arts and language in Thailand. She will do so while continuing her successful car racing career. Watch out for Minnie, she's destined for success. Kaisei. Kaisei has shown incredible personal growth and maturity in his journey through Bangkok Prep sixth form. He's shown great adaptability and remains humble with regards to his musical abilities and other successes outside of school. Success has also come in his studies of business, winning Student of the Month multiple times. He leaves us to continue developing his talents, reading business, and no doubt creating a few more businesses of his own along the way. We will miss you, Kaisei. Shepro. Shepro and his brilliant shirt collection exemplifies what it means to be a student at Bangkok Prep. He shows great enthusiasm in everything he does and won the Spirit of Bangkok Prep Award in 2022 as a result. He's been a house captain for Sabre and a school well-being ambassador. You can always count on Shepro to lead and to help others. He is a testament to our life values. Vanet. The form Wordle, GeoGuessr, and Quizmaster has shown incredible grit and determination in his Bangkok Prep sixth form years. Vanet has a never-stop-trying attitude that is truly inspirational. A popular member of the year group, we wish Vanet the very best of luck studying law in the UK. Gam. Gam. A talented and dedicated footballer, Gam has also been a key member of Smile Club since joining Bangkok Prep. She's achieved academic awards for her work in DT, exemplifying her well-rounded skill set. Gam hopes to develop these skills further by studying architecture at university. Yumi. On her academic journey, Yumi has proven herself to be a diligent, receptive, and adaptive student. While working incredibly hard, she has also found time to give back to society by contributing to a whole range of community projects, including Help More Thai and Operation Smile. To be able to leave a positive legacy is something we all aim for. Yumi has achieved that already. Mimi. Mimi is an incredibly well-balanced young lady who, although determined to fulfill her academic ambitions, has managed her time exceptionally. She's been able to be academic, sporty, charitable, and complete the Duke of Edinburgh International Award. Most importantly, though, Mimi is a thoroughly kind and likeable young person. Her work as an art prefect this year will support her future as she goes to study communication design in the US. Congratulations, 13SD. I've absolutely loved being your form tutor, and I wish you all the best.
Thank you, Ms. Dand. And now I'd like to welcome Mr. Kubit onto the stage.
First, Charlotte had a swish final year at Bangkok Prep as she leaves officially being the best three-pointer shooter in the school. Sorry, guys. Last week, she won Bangkok Prep's democratically named Sports Person of the Year award. Charlotte has been one of the key performers in the football and basketball team and captained the football team, who became the winners of the plate at the Phuket Sevens. Charlotte has an outstanding year academically, and she plans to continue studying psychology at Bristol next year. Annie. In her time at Bangkok Prep, Annie has made the most amazing friends. One of her favorite moments was laughing her way through the Year 13 residential. Annie is currently studying English, history, and psychology. One of the proudest moments at Bangkok Prep is moving from a D all the way to an A in history. She was thrilled when she received an offer from every university she applied to. Next year, Annie will be studying social sciences in Bath. Ken describes himself as handsome, smart, and shredded. He is also a maths master, so he should probably tell you about his exceptional brain too. Ken has been a strong member of the community, supporting students as a maths tutor and in the economics society. Every Friday after school, Ken plays football with his peers. He wanted to thank Bangkok Prep as this is the place where he's made his best friends. Next year, Ken will be studying quantitative finance and computer science in Hong Kong. Denzel is an extremely engaging member of the Bangkok Prep. In year 12, he was deputy head boy and also starred in the drama productions. Denzel is an excellent leader who listens and learns from others as he has grown exponentially in his time with us. He is extremely conscientious and has made a huge impact at our school. Thank you, Denzel. I'm sure he'll continue to bring joy into people's lives at the University of Melbourne. Ern is a hard-working, determined, and focused student, studying chemistry, biology, and maths. She has proven herself to be a driven student. Her favorite moments from her 4 years spent at Bangkok Prep were the yearly residential trips. In the future, Ern wants to become a dentist and is going to continue studies in the Thai University. She is destined to keep us all smiling for years. Eclair. She is unfortunately not here today. Eclair is a talented artist producing outstanding acrylic landscape and beautiful interpretive portraiture. This was best exemplified in her winning Best Art Student at Bangkok Prep this year. Don't start a row with Eclair either, as she has also coached the Bangkok Prep debate team. Next year, she is going to study political science in the UK. Eclair is also a compassionate and caring leader at the front of 4 community projects, including fundraising to help refugees and migrants, with donations going to the UNHCR and Red Cross. Unfortunately, she cannot be here today, but she'll be here on Monday for the prize-giving awards. So let's give her a shout out, please. Michael. Michael has established himself as a key member of our form and community during his time here. And undoubtedly, his active participation in Bangkok Prep's sports teams has been an important part of that. Michael has represented Bangkok Prep, the football team, and the athletics team in 100 meters long jump and high jump. He says he's a very charming young man, and his favorite moment at Bangkok Prep was watching his peer Leo get sunburnt on residential. Maybe not so charming. Michael's next steps will see him heading to Madrid to study business. Lottie. Lottie is an extremely driven and focused student and an important member of the Bangkok Prep community. She has shown this by achieving above her predicted grades across all academic subjects. However, it's not all positive. One of her favorite things to do at Bangkok Prep was to receive a weekly blues note for using the lift. Lottie brought her determination and drive. She brought her determination and drive to the sports teams with an exceptional performance across multiple disciplines, including winning the plate at the Phuket Sevens tournament and captaining the rugby team. Thank you, Lottie. Prem. I struggle to think of a more kind-hearted student than Prem. He is incredibly caring and considerate of his peers. Every Friday after school, Prem would play football with his friends, representing the community spirit at Bangkok Prep. You make us very proud, Prem. As a student, Prem is keen to learn, and next year is going to study business and entrepreneurship at a Thai university. Elizabeth. Elizabeth has studied at Bangkok Prep since year 8 and has been a key member of the community. As a student, she has shown drive and resilience, improving dramatically in geography. When asked what was her best moment at Bangkok Prep, she said she didn't know. I like to think this is because she just could not choose and enjoyed all the elements of Bangkok Prep. We certainly enjoyed and benefited from your time here, Elizabeth. Thank you very much. Trisha. And finally, Trisha is a highly creative student who has shone in her passion for the arts in drama and her media studies coursework. She has shown herself to be caring and passionate about voice and human rights. Trisha has been part of the Bangkok Prep Equality Team. Next year, she'll be going to university in Thailand where she'll be pursuing a career in the media industry. We hope representation will improve as a result of your career. Well done, Trisha. Thirteen TC, you made my first year at Bangkok Prep a very positive and memorable time. Thank you and well done.
Thank you, Mr. Cubitt. Please could I ask our honours guests to sit before I introduce our final act. But before I do, I'd like to congratulate SD and TC. Yeah, go on then. Okay, so could you now put your hands together for our final act of the evening, performing smooth for the final time, Bangkok Prep's favourite, Untamed.
Thank you.
That was a class performance from Untamed. Francis, could you just please remain near the stage as you're quite not done yet? Okay then, so to the class of 23, today is all about you. But before I pass you back to Francis, there are a couple of things that I'd like to say to you, really weird and wonderful lot. You've been a hugely significant part of my life for the past 5 years, and for good reason. Whether you've been part of this truly exceptional cohort for 5, 10, or for a select few of you, 15 years, your actions and your presence have made someone's time here at Bangkok Prep memorable. You only need to ask the 26 students that visited the primary campus this morning the impact that you have had on this school. You inspire and push those around you to be the very best versions of themselves, students and staff. Class of 23, this is far from the end. The relationships you have fostered and built during your time at Bangkok Prep will last a lifetime. Trust me. If you take a quick look around you now, you know, have a quick look at each other. You are looking at people who will be with you for significant milestones in your life. On that note though, please don't forget where you came from and more importantly, who put you there. Could I please now ask you to take a quick look behind you or maybe give a wave to those people that are watching at home? Even for those of you that are not going to countries far and wide, please remember this tiny piece of advice. Call your parents and loved ones. You might think that you're an adult now, and you are, but to some very significant people in your lives, you are still their baby boy or baby girl. You would not be here if it were not for these people who have supported and guided you, so please remember to let them know how appreciated they are. If that is my last piece of advice, then let this be my last request. Promise me you'll continue to look out for one another. It's been one of the greatest honors to watch you grow into the phenomenal young adults that sit before me now. You know how important it is to care for one another with compassion and empathy. You know how important it is to listen and support one another, and you know how important it is to enjoy one another's company with kindness. Please always carry that with you. Year 13, oh, thank you. Thank you for making me lose my hair. Thank you for always being late. But most importantly, thank you for giving me the privilege of being part of your journey into the world. You have given me memories that will live with me for a lifetime, and I can't wait to hear what's around the corner for each and every one of you. You're going to be amazing. Thank you. Okay. Let's get me off the stage. Now, before I welcome Francis back, I'd just like to take a moment to personally thank her for all she has done for the year group, the school, and the wider Bangkok Prep community. Not just these past few months, but in the 15 years she's been at Bangkok Prep. A tremendous amount of work goes on behind the scenes for events like this, and Francis has been at the heart of it all throughout her time here. It's students like her that really epitomize what this cohort is all about and Bangkok Prep. Francis, we have been so blessed to have you. Year 13, can we have a huge round of applause for our head student, Francis.
Thank you, Mr. Holt, for the kind words. You're about to make me cry before I speak. It's not good. Welcome all honored guests, family, friends, teachers and staff, our guest speaker, Khun Kon, and most of all, the distinguished class of 2023. I stand here for the final time to address you as your head girl, feeling both privileged and emotional. 15 years ago, I completed my first day at Bangkok Prep, and in 5 days, I will complete my last. This day always seemed so far away, and now that it has arrived, I find myself for the first time in my life speechless. So I'm glad that I've gotten something written for the occasion, because otherwise I wouldn't know what I would do. From my first steps through Bangkok Prep's gates over a decade ago to this momentous occasion, I have continuously felt the embrace of a warm community. And having spent my entire school career here, the school has naturally become a large part of my identity. The culture that we have fostered here, the 11 life values that we have embodied, and the lessons that we have learned have woven themselves into the fabric that makes up who we are as people today. Therefore, I'm sure my classmates can all agree with the saying, once a bulldog, always a bulldog, will ring true to us as we move on to the next chapters of our lives. Through it all, Bangkok Prep has been my second home, my family, and my foundation. And although I am sad to be leaving, I know that no matter what, No matter how far I go or how old I get, Bangkok Prep will always be there for me, for all of us. I'm honored to be speaking to you all today on behalf of my graduating class. To our teachers, who have dedicated their time and effort to ensure we have the best education possible, thank you. You've worked tirelessly to support us, encourage us, reply to our emails sent in the dead of night, and somehow remain calm when we sanded our fingertips off in the DT lab. You have been more than just teachers here at Bangkok Prep. You have been our support systems, and most of all, you have been our friends. Admittedly, you have made saying goodbye to this school very difficult. Thank you for being our unwavering mentors. We will always be appreciative of your guidance through the years. To our beloved parents, thank you for giving us the opportunity to attend Bangkok Prep, for shaping us into who we are, and for the boundless love and support you have shown us. Thank you, mums, dads, grandparents, aunts, uncles, siblings, cousins. You have been there for all of the rejection, the struggle, and the success. Much like the rest of my class, I know I would especially like to dedicate a huge thank you to my parents for filling my house with books, music, and laughter, which has made me into the student I am today. Thank you all for getting my peers and I through our years at school. We would not be here today without your unflagging support. Lastly, to my 70 fellow graduates, I want to express my deepest gratitude for the vibrant experiences we have shared over the years. We have been through thick and thin together, from cramming for exams, which some of us only finished yesterday, to experiencing countless other joys of school life. We've laughed together, we've cried together, we've read some questionable anecdotal literature together, and we've even caught COVID together. Thank you for dodgeball, for assassinator, for the dreaded results days, for the residentials, and for coincidentally catching day-long illnesses on PSHE days. Through it all, we have forged unbreakable bonds, creating memories that will last a lifetime, friendships that will last a lifetime. You have made every day worthwhile, and your company will be sorely missed as we go our separate ways. I wish you all the best of luck in everything that you do, and hope that our paths will cross again someday along the line. Finally, I would like to leave you with the words of F. Scott Fitzgerald, who wrote, "I hope you live a life that you're proud of. If you find that you're not, I hope you have the strength to start all over again. Bangkok Prep, you have made me into who I am, and I will be forever indebted to you. Thank you for everything. Congratulations to the class of 2023.
The love, y'all, y'all.
As the youth are young, so ask yourself, is the loving really gone? So I could ask myself, really, what is going wrong in this world that we living in. People keep on giving in, making wrong decisions, only visions of them dividends. Not respecting each other, denies thy brother. A war's going on, but the reason's undercover. The truth is kept secret, it's swept under the rug. If you never know truth, then you never know love. What's the love, y'all? Come on. What's the truth, y'all? Come on. What's the love, y'all?
People killing, people dying, children hurt, pain, and crying. When you practice what you preach, and what you turn the other cheek. Father, 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 help us. Send some guidance from above. These people got me questioning. Where is the love?
Where is the love? Where is the love?
Where is the love? The love, the love.
I feel the weight of the world on my shoulder. As I'm getting older, your people gets colder. Most of us only care about money making. Selfishness got us following the wrong direction. Wrong information always shown by the media. Negative images is the main criteria. Infecting the young minds faster than bacteria. Kids wanna act like what they see in the cinemas. Whatever happened to the values of humanity? Whatever happened to the fairness and equality? Instead of spreading love, we're spreading animosity. Lack of understanding leading us away from unity. That's the reason why sometimes I'm feeling under. That's the reason why sometimes I'm feeling down. It's no wonder why sometimes I'm feeling under. Gotta keep my faith alive, love is found. Now ask yourself,
where is the love? Where is the love? Where is the love? One world, one world.
We only got
one world, one world.
That's all we got.
One world, one world.
And something's wrong with it. Yeah. Something's wrong with it.
Yeah.
Something's wrong with the good world, world. Yeah. We only got
one world, one world.
That's all we got.
One
Thank you, honoured guests, teachers, staff and parents, families and friends, for joining us on this special afternoon. Thank you to the graduation team for masterminding, organising and delivering a graduation to remember. One member of that team this year was actually a member of this year group. His pathway took him to university in the UK 1 year early, and today, he's here working at the school, most recently seen up in the box. Can we give Magnum his own round of applause, please? And I want to say thank you for that video, Year 13. What a wonderful way to very, very nearly conclude our graduation ceremony. Now that I've regained a little composure, I want to say thank you to the students who led, decided what to make, and put that together. It was wonderful to see so many people included in that video. Those that are here in the auditorium today, and the young adults from all around the world whose pathways took them elsewhere along our journey. Many of Year 13 made their way to secondary school under the careful guidance of Mr. Stonehouse and Mr. Owen, and our primary colleagues. And that song, Black Eyed Peas, I think, that was performed at 53 on the auditorium there. It was performed as a flash mob with the purpose and the intention of communicating an important message and it's one of kindness. So thank you for bringing back those memories for each other and for living and extending that message of kindness. That is one message that I hope we all take with us today and we keep for the rest of our lives. In reaching out to the alumni who have already headed to different parts of the world and including them in this video, you demonstrated something that I must emphasize. Once you are a member of our Bangkok Prep community, you are always a member of our Bangkok Prep community. As our alumni, you're going to continue to inspire everyone that follows in your footsteps. You join a growing network of people that have graduated and gone on to do amazing things. Stay in touch with us. Come back and see us. You are the role models growing in our wonderful and fantastic community. So year 13, you've completed your commencement walk. You've been on the stage and collected your diploma. There are just two traditions left. Now the final tradition will take place elsewhere at 3:30. Which means it's my honor now to ask you for a final time together as the class of year 2023. Please, year 13, would you stand? And united, take your tassels and move them from the right to the left. This simple tradition symbolizes your matriculation from students and graduands to graduates. Please, let's give a huge round of applause to our fantastic class of 2023. Thank you, students. Thank you for enriching our lives, year 13, and becoming the young people that we celebrated today. You are a credit to your generation and to yourselves. I have an answer to the question, where is the love? It's in this room. And I ask you now, please go to find your family, your friends, and make your way down to enjoy further celebrations downstairs, because 3:30 is almost here. Congratulations, everyone.